Hi everyone, I hope you're doing well. Welcome to a new studio vlog. Today I'm gonna show you how I've made my very new bookmarks that are available on my Etsy shop if you want to check them out. For the first time, I'm using this foil quill kit that is really nice to add some gold details. I love to use my gold pen that you have already seen, but this is really nice and this is different. You get a different type of gold in a way. You'll see the final result. I've bought the fine tip one, but you also have two bigger tips available too. I wanted something pretty thin and to get, pretty cute and small details. There are different adapters in the kit, so you can use this kit with different cutting machine. I have the silhouette portrait too, but if you have the Cricut machine or another cutting machine, you can also use this kit. So this is really cool. I've also bought some gold foil, but you have other colors available. You can also buy some silver or some pink or blue or purple, whatever you want. It's almost like a pen, but with a heating tip, which pushes the foil onto the paper. You can plug it directly on your computer, or you can use an external battery. The adapter for the silhouette portrait 2 is the A type, so you put the heating pen in it and then you plug the adapter with the heating pen in your silhouette portrait 2 or your cutting machine. You also have this little tool in the kit to avoid that the pen heats up on your machine, so it helps to protect your machine from the heat while the pen is heating up, because you actually need to wait 5 minutes for it to be warm enough to be able to use the technique. And you also need to place the foil onto the paper, and I usually use some washi tape to do that and stick it. Then here you can see me plug my external battery for the pen to heat up and the tip to be warm enough to be able to get the gold effects. You need to prepare your file and put your machine in the drawing mode. So the pen heats up the paper and the gold comes onto it. And then you have your final result. So it's really simple. It's, as I said, almost like a pen, so it's easy to get a nice result and really easy to use. I still had some trial and errors, but it was mostly because of the file that I've made on Silhouette Studio, and maybe I don't know how I placed the paper or something, I don't know exactly, but it wasn't because of the pen or of the foil or anything like that. So the technique is really easy to use and easy to get a nice result. Then you have to have the right settings and the right file and everything correct, but yeah, accept that it's really nice and easy to use. Here you can see the first one on a white paper. Let me know what you think about the gold details and the design. I've decided to make 3 bookmarks to sell them in a kit, so they are available in a kit on my Etsy shop if you're interested. I also wanted to use a craft brown paper, so I've done another file for that, and I didn't tell you, but I've made the design on my iPad on Procreate first and then created the cutting and designing files on Silhouette Studio. And again, I don't know exactly why, but it was pretty hard to get the right result on the brown paper. As you can see here, that's a failure. And I don't know exactly why, but you can see that the gold details are perfect. They are just not at the right place. So I think there were something wrong in my file or something. But then I finally made it, and I also used my white pen with my pen adapter to add also some details in white, so you have some black, white and gold details on the bookmark, so it's really cute and really nice. I love it. Here I'm cutting it by hand, but I then created a cutting file so I can also cut it with my machine, which is cool because that saves me some time. The only thing that I haven't done yet, but I know that I can do it with my cutting machine, is to get the round corners. So I used this tool to cut the corners and get something round. But now that I'm a bit more familiar with the Silhouette Studio, the software of the machine, because that also saves some time. The final result of this one is also really nice. Let me know what you think of it. The gold details are so cute and so well done, so I'm really happy about them. I would love to know what you think. And I think my favorite is the last one that you're gonna see now. So I've decided to make the third one on black paper. So in the kit you have the white, the brown and the black bookmarks. So it's really cool, I think, and it's a way to also represent diversity, to have these different colors, and they are so nice together. And I don't know, I just love these bookmarks. I'm only using some neutral tones, so if you're someone who doesn't like too many colors, I think you may like these bookmarks. I wanted to do something a bit different this time. I hope you like them, and I hope they help us remember the importance of diversity and love before all. So let me know what you think of them. On the black paper, I couldn't print anything, so I've used my white pen and the gold foil to get the details and the design. It looks really, really nice. I also had some trial and errors, but it was still pretty easy to make. The only thing is, for all of these bookmarks, they take more time to make than the previous bookmark that I've made. So yeah, they take time, and I have to be patient and be careful when I apply the gold foil and everything, but I really, really love the result. For this one, I also have to be careful and not take off the paper before adding all the details. So I've used the white pen, then add the gold details, and I didn't move the paper at all because I cannot place any marks, so the machine cannot know where to add the details if I move the paper. So that's really important. But it's still easy to make, and the result is so, so nice. I love all of them, but this is so cool, I think. And I have to cut this one by hand. I cannot cut it with my machine. Guess it's time to say, baby, baby, how you make me feel when you come to my... They're so nice together. Let me know which one you like the most, and let me know what you think about these bookmarks. My cool, baby, baby. I can't hold it inside. I can't wait. They are now available on my Etsy shop. Please go check them out if you are interested. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoy. Please like, leave me a comment, because I would love to know what you think. And subscribe to keep watching my videos. I hope to see you soon. Bye.